Unemployment in the United States has dropped in recent years from a high of 10% in 2009 during the recession to a low of 4.1% in 2017. Yet wages are not keeping up.
Employment gains continue and wage gains continue. It's just that wage gains are very, very slow given the fact that the United States is now close to full employment.
Historically, wages rise when unemployment numbers fall. Economists consider a jobless rate below 5% to be akin to full employment. At that level, demand for workers should drive up the amount companies are willing to pay to keep them on their payrolls, but wages have only risen by 2.5% over the past year.
This has been a puzzling recovery from the point of view of job market because low unemployment, declining unemployment, has not produced the substantial gains in wages that ordinarily we anticipate when it gets harder for employers to fill vacancies.
And while nationally wages are only growing at a modest pace, some metropolitan areas are seeing big wage increases. According to the Labor Department, in 2017, unemployment in San Jose, California, at just 3%, was more than 1 point lower than the national average. And workers there saw their wages increase 3% over 1 year. It was a similar story in Denver and Miami, metropolitan jobless rates lower than the national average, with wage gains between 3 and 4%.
In cities that are very blessed by strongly expanding industries, they have had to attract workers from elsewhere. It's necessary for employers to offer better working conditions, higher wages, better fringe benefits.
The big question, can the wage growth seen in a few cities translate to workers across the country?
Employers have held out a long, long time, giving their workers very slow wage gains. And workers do not seem to be walking off the job or beginning labor strikes or anything like that. When workers collectively have greater bargaining power, maybe then we can anticipate that wages would start growing faster.